Breaking news on a member of the U.S. Congress announcing she won't seek re-election after admitting she failed to protect women on her staff from sexual abuse and harassment. Let's go to our congressional correspondent, Sunland Sarfati. Sunland, the Connecticut Democrat, Elizabeth Esty, has faced very harsh criticism for her mishandling of these allegations against her chief of staff.
That's right. Well, if the Congresswoman has been under an incredible amount of pressure to resign over her handling of this situation in her office. And tonight, while she says she is keeping her seat, she announced that she will now no longer run for re-election.
Tonight, embattled Congresswoman Elizabeth Esty is bowing out, writing on Facebook today, "I have determined that it is in the best interest of my constituents and my family to end my time in Congress at the end of this year and not seek re-election."
My name's Elizabeth Esty.
Esty had been under fire for mishandling allegations of sexual harassment and abuse within her congressional office, allowing her chief of staff to remain on the job for 3 months after learning of his alleged pattern of harassment and abuse against a female staffer. The Congresswoman admitting tonight, "In the terrible situation in my office, I could have and should have done better. To the survivor, I want to express my strongest apology for letting you down." Pressure had been mounting for days on the Congresswoman.
"This mistake is too egregious to get past, and it's time for her to step aside." Not only did the Congresswoman not act, but that he continued to lead that staff for 3 months after the fact.
The embattled Congresswoman had launched a behind-the-scenes damage control operation, attempting to save her political future, today calling for the House Ethics Committee to investigate her handling of the allegations, and writing a Dear Colleague letter to lawmakers on Capitol Hill, questioning, "How did I not know? How did I not see it? What I do know is that wasn't an isolated incident on Capitol Hill, and that we can and must do better to ensure a safe environment for our employees." Sources close to the Congresswoman tell CNN she spent the weekend working the phones, calling allies in Connecticut and on Capitol Hill to gauge the political damage. Apparently, it was not enough. A top Democrat in the House, Nancy Pelosi, breaking her silence today, reprimanding Esty, saying her actions did not protect the victim.
And Esty's former chief of staff does not dispute that he took part in some abusive behavior, including sexual harassment and berating of a female staffer. But he does deny some of the allegations being made against him. And tonight, in a new statement, he is apologizing to his alleged victim, to the Congresswoman, and he says to any other people, Wolf, who were hurt by his actions.
I think her decision not to seek re-election sends a very, very strong message to a lot of her colleagues out there as well. They're going to be very, very cautious in dealing with these sensitive issues. Sunland, thank you so much for that report, Sunland Sarfati.